Let me introduce to you our mother, Mataji Nirmala Devi.
Yesterday, as I told you, that we are going to have a series one after another. And yesterday I explained to you the introductory part of Sahaja. As I said, Saha means with, Ja means born. Is born, it is inborn, is spontaneous, is living. Whatever is born with you is living, for your fingers, hands, everything is living. And this system is born. Yoga means the union with your spirit. Simple, it's very simple meaning. Yoga means to join. To join you with your spirit, with the divine. This is born with you. This right to be one with the divine is born with you. It's your birthright. That is Sahaja Yoga. Now, to say that it is my method or it is today's method would not be correct. Because this is the method of anything that is spontaneous. Like you see a seed sprouting, a flower becoming a fruit, an egg becoming a bird, or you see a caterpillar becoming a butterfly. All this is sahaja, is inborn within us. And this is existing within us, of which people were aware thousands and thousands of years back. Not only in India, you'll be surprised. They were aware in England, they were definitely aware in Egypt, they were aware in Greece. Recently I went to Greece, to Athens, and I was surprised. Athens word comes from the word Athena. Athena is their goddess. Actually they don't know much about her, but Atha in Sanskrit means primordial. She is the primordial Kundalini. Athena is the primordial Kundalini, the mother of the expressed as the primordial Kundalini or the primordial mother. And she has in her hand a snake which goes round into circles creating chakras. It's so clearly shown. But they are not aware of it. And they even have, you'll be amazed, the daughter of that Athena, which is placed in among all of us. And they call this bone as sacrum, means a sacred bone. The word sacrum has come from Greek language. Is the sacrum, means the sacred bone, that they were aware that in this bone lies something that is very sacred. And I asked them, how did you get this idea? Was that Alexander the Great who brought these ideas to you? They said, no, this is thousands of years back, we had a rapport with people who were Indians, Indo-Aryan groups, and that's how we know about it. It's most amazing. And so many other things I discovered which was so surprising and so enlightening that these people were very much aware of. Now in England there's a place called Stonehenge. I went to see that place. Stonehenge has tremendous vibration. Tremendous vibration. The whole working of it is nothing but a 3.5 coil. It is placed and it has come out of the Mother Earth. But people did not understand. They started covering it up and all, they made it into some sort of a pattern. But actually the main things must have just come out of the Mother Earth. And it has tremendous vibration and people don't understand what it was. That means people did practice this Kundalini business there. I went to Colombia. I was surprised in Colombia. They told me that the emblem of the Navy is a What do you call that? Condor. Condor is called as a Garuda in Indian language. I don't know if you know. It's a very big eagle-like thing, condor. And they said condor is the emblem. I said, why condor? I mean, what has condor to do with the Navy? I can't understand. So they said it is because our old people tell us that from India, that is Bharat, from India, a god called Vishnu came on a condor. Thousands of years back, these people said about Vishnu who came on a condor. I mean, I was amazed at their description, and how did they know? I said, how do you know? I said, it is sent. And that's why we put it at condor. We said, it's all right, we'll have condor, because condor is very much respected. There is no condor available there. Nobody sees them there. Nobody knows much about it. But why they talk about condor is because their Indians say that Vishnu came on a condor to their country. Now, where is Colombia? Where is it? If you see their patterns of their ornaments, it's absolutely what we do in India, is to use the wire on top of the gold. I don't know if you have seen their gold ornaments. They had taken an exhibition round. But all of that is all Indian pattern. They said the Indians came down to teach us now. I don't know how Indians went in those days to teach them. It's most surprising how they had a record in those days, and they lost the links. Like in, say, from Iceland, I met a lady, and I just asked her, what do you say for sugar in your language? And she said that it's called as sharkara. Now, sharkara is a pure Sanskrit word for sugar, pure Sanskrit. Now, then we discovered that the Sanskrit must have started somewhere near Norway, because it is said that it started at a place where that Rohini Nakshatra is one of the constellations, is at Raita. Now, that's the place where it is at right angle. Is Norway the place where it is at right angle? So maybe that the pre-Latin language got purified into Sanskrit. There was a big report in this time, and one became the Latin, another became the Sanskrit. And there are so many common words and common concepts that it's remarkable how we have lost contacts and how we are separated now, even as nations. I went to Australia and I was surprised the language that they use has mostly Sanskrit words. Like the river on which we were, on the bank of which we were living, was called as Paramata, means the primordial mother. I was surprised how this name was given to that river, Paramata. I asked any Indian, he will know about it. And it's something that we had an all-pervading knowledge of this, even in England. And must be in America also. I should find out some places where I'll be able to locate these things. Especially the old Indians who lived in America. I saw them in Chile and in Argentina and in Colombia. And they knew so many Sanskrit words in their ritualism and all that. I was amazed how the Sanskrit was with them. From where did it spread? And how did they have this knowledge of Kundalini? But this knowledge was a secret knowledge for many years, thousands of years. There was a poet called as Markandeya, who lived, I think, they say, about 10,000 years back. He has described about the Kundalini. But he has just described that she resides here and she is awakened and she passes those chakras and all that. But not in details and not very clearly, in a very mystic language. Now, what happened in the beginning when people started their civilization, say, in India, they first were faced with the nature. Though in India, nature is very kind. You can live under a tree or you can live under a any shade that you can get, even in a cave, and you can be quite happy and you can eat some fruits. And the climate is so good, it's not so cold and so hot and all that, so one can live very happily. And they had solved their problems like these, some people, and they were living in the forest, and they started thinking about their own existence. Why are we here? And when they started thinking about it, they meditated. And in meditation, they discovered lots of things. And the thing that discovered that we have within ourselves a residual power called as Kundalini. And this residual power is the power which is not manifested. It is sleeping. It has created the whole of the universe that we are, and yet not manifested, because it has to manifest, giving you your self-realization. This is the power of desire within us, the desire to become one with the Spirit. And that's how they believe that there is this power that existed in all human beings and that it should be awakened. Today I'm trying to give you the little history of this, because one by one we'll be going through the whole thing. Now there is another group of people who just felt that first of all we must try to master the elements. And from these seers, they got information to do that you must use the fire element, worship the fire element. And they started worshipping the fire element and started doing the Homa and Havanas, and the Vedas were written for exciting the fire element and other elements, all the five elements. So all the Vedas were written how to master these elements by pleasing the deities that rule us. Even in Greece they believed that everything has a deity, like they called the Varuna, we call it as the one Neptune, the one who is the lord of the sea, is called as Poseidon. They call it Poseidon to that special deity like that. And they believed in it that that is so. The trouble is at that time they did not start rationalizing or sort of deducting it on this. They believed in their seers, and whatever their seers told them they believed it, and they started working on that, and they wanted to excite these elements. The result of that is today's modern science. The modern science that we have got it because we have been able to master these five elements. Now these five elements also that we have mastered. In our own freedom we might have created lots of problems for ourselves. For example, we have created an atom bomb. One can say that by mastering this, what we have done is to create an atom bomb and a neutron bomb and this bomb and that bomb. But also for your good. Because once you have created it, it's sitting like a devil there. Now you are all frightened of it and no more wars. Because if any more wars start, you are all going to be finished like that. So even this devil that you have created is frightening you from there and grinning at you, all right, you have created me, now you better behave yourself. All such enterprises move in one linear direction and they recoil back. Anything you try, now you try to create plastic, now plastic is sitting on your head. You don't know what to do with your plastic. You do anything like that, it comes back on you and it challenges you. For example, now we can say that when we have got everything around, I mean in New York, you see, you have got cars, you've got you can move about, you've got food, you've got affluence as it is, you are affluent people. But people are running away from affluence. They have taken to counter-cultures. They are fed up with this, all these plastics, nylons, finished with it, and now they are seeking something else. They are taking drugs and running away. They don't want to carry the junks of their parents. They are different type of people that are born. The same thing for which they were striving so much has now bothered them so much that they are trying to run away. So the reaction is built in on all these endeavors that we do with the elements, because elements cannot give you joy. No matter can give us joy. We think it can. For example, if you want to build a house, all right, I must build a house, I must have mortgage, I must have this, that, and you build the house. Still you are sitting miserable as if there is mourning on. What's the matter? Now I must have a car. All right, you have a car. You have a car, you have a house and everything, and then you want to wear torn clothes. Why? Because now I belong to counterculture. Why did you strive so much to have a house and a car and all that pomp and show and style, and now you are going for a counterculture? Because you are not satisfied. And basically economics says this very clearly, that one want is satiable in general, it is not satiable. The wants are not satiable in general. You want to have one thing, then you want to have another thing, want to have another thing. And then you get so fed up with these monkey tricks that you want to give up. You don't want to be monkeys anymore. Had enough of it. Like in England when I went, most of the people who came to me, I asked them, what are you doing? Mother, I am successfully unemployed. That's a big cry against unemployment. Mrs. Thatcher is so much worried that, you see, people are unemployed, but they are successfully unemployed. They want to be unemployed. That perhaps she does not know, that they don't want to work. Had enough of it, this madness, we don't want it. So they started running across, finding out, and the time has come now for many seekers to be born. Now seekers who are beyond the seeking of material life, they are fed up. They want to seek something. At this juncture, the market started sending the news to people that, this is the place where you can make money. So the thing got flooded, especially your America, with all the great thugs of the world to come down here and settle down nicely, exploiting. That's what it is. So the history of these people works out this way, that now they are here. And we do not know what to do with ourselves and with them. But one should know that the nature has made us a human being. He has created us from amoeba to this stage for some purpose. And if God has created this creation with such care and us with some creation, there must be some purpose. He is not going to allow his creation to be destroyed. These days in France, if you find anybody sitting on the street, they are discussing that there is going to be a catastrophe. In 82, they say. And then in everything is going to be destroyed, so why worry? Better drink before that as much as you can. So they are sitting on the streets with the bottles in their hand till they get absolutely drunk. They said, after all, we are going to be destroyed in any case, so waiting for that, they are just worried about that. So they told me that in New York, they are discussing only two things. I said, well, which two things they are discussing? One is a dollar, in the American way, dollar, you can say. And the another is the miseries and the sufferings. I said, really? That's the only thing they are talking about. Is one is the dollar and the subsequent suffering one has to go through. It's most surprising how we reach a point of a proper conclusion of everything. But still we do not hit the right point. We reach a right conclusion, understanding that matter is not the thing that is going to give us joy. We have to go beyond. There's something beyond we have to achieve. Whether you are a communist or whether you are a capitalist or anything, everybody knows that this is not satisfied. I've been to Russia myself. And the Russians I met, they said, but there must be something beyond this, isn't it? It's not everything. Every one of them said true. Every one of them. So same here. And that, when it comes to that point, then only a mass evolution has to take place. And many people have to get realization, no doubt about it. So on the right-hand side, they try to discover all the elements and all that, and they put that. First, the desire came into people that we should do something about it. And when they found that this one, it seems a little funny to work it out all the time, running after matter, so they took to another style of emotional, that is devotion, is to surrender yourself. Surrender anything to anything. Like anybody comes in and says, now this is what I am. All right, surrender. Surrender your brain. Surrender your understanding, surrender your logic, surrender your wisdom, everything to that, and just you'll be all right. And that's how then we found that all these incarnations who came on this earth, a great incarnation like Christ, great incarnation like Muhammad, great incarnation like so many other people who came in India, like Rama, Krishna and all these, they made a nice pickle out of that. They started big, huge organizations and big, huge places. And though they were every time challenged, like I would say that papal authority was challenged by Martin Luther, who was a realized soul, all the people who followed Martin Luther went into another extreme of licentiousness and policymakers. So from this end to that end and from that end to this end, when they came on this side, they became very, very sort of ascetic, and they said, oh, we all should become nuns and we should lead a life of absolute celibacy. I don't know where Christ has said that. I don't think he could have said it, that you become nuns. It is nonsensical. It is unnatural to be nuns and all that. And they look so horrid and so hot-tempered. I mean, they have no sweetness about them. I mean, I don't know if you have been to convents. Look at the children. They just shake when they see a nun supposed to be a sister. And they just shake and they just don't want to look at them. And these are the people in charge of God and going to marry Christ. Of all the things, that's the worst thing that you can do, is to say that you are going to marry Christ. It's something, I don't know from where it came into their heads, that they are marrying Christ. What right have they got to marry Christ? How are they connected with him? I just don't understand. But all sorts of nonsense, this is the greatest nonsense that they established on this earth, and they started huge big nunneries and huge big, what you call these churches and all that. The worst thing they did was to, in the church, to put all the dead bodies. I don't know from where did they get this idea also, I just don't understand. In the Bible, where is it written that you build all your churches on the dead people, walk on top of them, bring all your children to those cemeteries? But all sorts of nonsense they did in Christianity, worst and worst in Hinduism. I need not tell you about Hindus, the amount of nonsense they have done. The person like Adi Shankaracharya who came in the 6th century, he talked of nothing else but what I'm telling you. If you read his book, any book, I don't know if they are translated. Nothing else but what I'm telling you, that you have to become the spirit. That you have to get realization. Once you get realization, you get over all your jati. Jati means your aptitudes. All these caste systems were based on the aptitudes of a person. Not on the prenatal system that you are born to a Brahmin, you are a Brahmin. You could be a Shudra born to a Brahmin. It's an aptitude. A one who is a seeker is a Brahmin. The one who wants to know about the Brahma, wants to know about God, is a Brahmin, is an aptitude. It's really an aptitude, because if it was not so, Gita was written by Vyasa. Vyasa, he was a great sage, and he wrote Gita. And do you know his, I must tell you about his birth. He was born to a lady, illegitimate child, who was just a fisherwoman, and who married another man later on. This was Vyasa who wrote Gita. And how can you say, in Gita it is written, can you imagine that your caste, your aptitude is determined by your birth? Can you believe it? The one who is an illegitimate child, will he write like this? Luckily he was illegitimate, so today we can say that it is nonsense you have put it. And this is, all such things have been done to all the all the scriptures they have tried to spoil for their own purpose. Now, like Muhammad, you can't imagine how he lived. His life was misery, and people tortured him, these mad people there. I don't know why did he take his birth there. It would have been better if he had taken birth in India. People would have respected him. He did later on. But the way they tortured him, this is nomadic people, they had no idea of God, nothing. He wanted them to know about God. He went there, they poisoned him, they tortured him, they never listened to him. And ultimately when he died, then they said that he said that, I am the last prophet. He might have said it also, might have said, doesn't matter. But he saw the way they were behaving, and he again reincarnated. He has to, any sensible man would be, mother may say, this is the last time I'm coming to you. Last time I did say to Americans, this is the last time I'm coming. But I had to come back, what to do? They had no sense at that time. I said, all right, this is the last time, I'm not coming. But after 9 years, I just couldn't help it. I said, all right, I must go back. Now you would say, you are the other mother, it cannot be the same. She had said that she will not come back. Really, I did say. But that doesn't mean I will not come back. In compassion and love, I have to come back. Because all my children are here, lost, what am I to do? I have to come back. And that's exactly what happened about Muhammad. And now Mr. Khomeini thinks that he is the topmost man in the kingdom of God. I mean, he's just next to God. God knows why he doesn't say he is also Bhagavan. He could say that he is Bhagavan. I mean, the way he is behaving, you can see now clearly how fanaticism can be dangerous. And this is what has happened in the human awareness also, that people accepted whatever was told to them. All these great incarnations are fruits or the flowers of the same living tree. But you take out the flowers from the tree and say, this is mine, fight over it. They become ugly and die. And then you say that, oh, this is the religion I follow, I believe. Now what is that I in you that believes? We should challenge ourselves. Now which one is this I, Mr. I within me, me that believes? Everybody says, even politicians, I believe. Now who is this I? This I is Mr. E.G.O. It's not your spirit. You are not your spirit. When you say, I believe, it is your spirit, then it is an absolute. It's the truth. All those who are realized souls believe in one. Because they become, all of them, collectively conscious, and they feel one. For example, if you have 10 children, and they are realized souls, you ask them to put hands towards one person and say, now where is wrong with this person? They will all show the same finger. Same finger they will show, it is here. Even the child, maybe a 6-month-old, he'll put his finger in the mouth. So Mr. Freud said, this is sex. Now what to do with this half-fake fellow who doesn't know anything? This Freud, who has taken you over completely. I don't know how you got into his mess. And all kinds of messes you have been into, and all sorts of cobwebs there have been. So now, the best is, first of all, get over your ego. That's the main part one has to play, and you have to become your spirit. Now, to become your spirit, you are beautifully neat. There is the Kundalini, there is the spirit in your heart, though the seat of the spirit is here. But it resides in human beings in the heart. Now, when the Kundalini rises, she passes through these centers and opens the Sahasrara. When this was going on, and the other side, the one where we were trying to sort of master the elements, and on the other side we were having these devotions and surrenderings and all that, the third side, which is very important, which is the evolutionary side, was also worked out. The third side is the evolutionary side. And the third side was working out, where people were working on this Kundalini and were using it for giving realization to others. Now, as it is, you know, people are doing Hatha Yoga very much in America. That's also another jumble. Because Hatha Yoga was practiced thousands of years back in India by Patanjali. Patanjali wrote about Hatha Yoga. When we had four type of ashramas, or four periods of our lives, in which the beginning of our lives was a brahmacharya, when you had to lead a celibate life, live with a realized guru, there was a university which you had to join, and this university was called as Gotra. Now for example, my Gotra is Shandilya. Now this was thousands of years back, my four fathers must have studied with Shandilya Muni, and even today I am Shandilya. Now I cannot marry anybody in Shandilya Gotra, even today. So you can imagine what was the celibacy. We are not only brothers and sisters, but the descendants of that even today cannot marry. This was the condition of the university, that in a university, when the boys went after 5 years of age, the girls lived there till the age of 25 years, and they led a life of brothers and sisters like a family in complete celibacy. At that time, Patanjali Shastra was. Are these the circumstances today? It is meant for people who are not at all exposed to sex, to begin. Second, it has got ashtangas. There are 8 parts, not one, 8 parts. Out of that is Yamaniyama is one of them. Out of Yama, 1/3 is the exercise, 1/3. So I don't know, you calculate how much part it is. And that nth part of this thing has become now Hatha Yoga. Now you start doing that exercise because for you Marilyn Monroe is your heroine, or maybe Mrs. Kennedy, I don't know who she is. Some sort of a person. So you must develop your legs like this and hands like this, and all the men are trying to reduce their waistline and doing all kinds of nonsensical things. I mean, this physical body should not be that important. On the contrary, one should try to keep it clean. Cleansing of the body is much more important. Cleansing in the way that you don't do anything wrong with your hands. You murder. There is no hole to enter into the God's kingdom where you have to have certain amount of these caricatures which can pass through. What you have to have is a holy hand, holy feet, holy eyes, holy appearances. It has to be holiness. Nobody paid attention to holiness. They all paid attention to these physical appearances. By this, they have lost a lot. And that's how what happens, you move too much on the right-hand side, looking after the physical being, which is only up to this part, and what you neglect is your spirit. So, all such people get heart attacks. Before getting heart attacks, they get emotionally drained out. They mostly have divorces. If they see somebody, you see they are like, we can say like fireballs. You don't touch them. Don't go near them. Even if you talk to them, they may come on you like dogs and just start howling at you. You do not know how to do it. They'll bark at you. You don't know why. Why they did it? Just because they are like that. They are so hot-tempered, so ego-oriented, and they think no end of themselves, and such people exist here, and so-called Hatha Yoga. There is no yoga at all. On the contrary, you run away from your spirit. You run away from your spirit. Only you develop your ego there. Now here, as you see clearly, there are two lines shown. One is the left side and the right side. Now this left line comes and creates that blue thing there. Now what is this left line? Is the power of desire. This power of desire manifests outside the left sympathetic nervous system on the gross. But we are showing here the subtler side of ours. Now on the right side, you have this another power which shows yellow of the bile color, is the power of action. So we act by our physical being and our mental being. So it's the physical and the mental, but the see, English language is a little funny, because when you say a mental patient, it means that something wrong on the left side. So what I mean is that the people who work out with planning and with rationality and all that, they use this part. And the people who use this part are the people who are doing physical labor or physical attention or hatha yogis and all those people who have thinned down beyond redemption. All such people are on this. On the other side, on the left-hand side, is the power of desire. Here the people who are emotional, like who go on singing praises of Sri Rama and Sri Krishna on the street of our Oxford street, to see with a thing hanging down and singing songs and shouting and spoiling their Vishuddhi chakra and getting cancer in the throat. They are on the left-hand side. Or the women who are extremely romantic and emotional and always crying and weeping and troubling others. And this type of people are on the left-hand side. Now this side, the left-hand side, this side, is the subconscious, and beyond this is the collective subconscious. And this side is the right-hand side, is our supraconscious, and beyond this is collective supraconscious. Now this is in Sanskrit is called Adhidaivik, and this is called as Adhibhautik. All these things are there, but nobody has told you. Now, when you go to these fake gurus, what they do is to push you on the left or to the right. Simple thing they do is to push you to the left or to the right. They can only do that. They cannot bring you up there, because here is the super consciousness. They cannot awaken your kundalini, they cannot raise it, so they push you on to the left or to the right. Now, beyond a certain area, the whole of the collective consciousness, collective subconsciousness, the whole, means from the creation. Now I was surprised that doctors have found out, thank God, that the cancer is caused by some proteins called 58, protein 58 and 56, they have even photographed, who come into the system and trigger the cancer, and they come from the area which was built within us since the time of our creation. But they don't know what it is. And I have told about this 10 years back that the cancer is caused by the left side move. Now, if these gurus put you onto the left hand side, what happens? You get possessed by those proteins. We call them boots of the dead spirit. You just get possessed, that's all. You just get possessed. You see, that's why you see, if a false guru is there, there are 50,000 people just mad, going like this, foolish, stupid people, don't understand anything what they are doing, or what they have to achieve, if they know, or there is nothing like finding out anything, no discrimination, like silly, useless lunatics. They move and they think, oh, we've got the knowledge. Now, what knowledge have you got? If you ask them, what is the knowledge? Can you say, what's wrong with this gentleman? Can you say, what's wrong with you? Do you know, where are you? Where is your kundalini? Oh, we don't believe in anything. We just believe in our guru. Now, what do you believe in guru? He is going to go to hell direct and you are going to follow him. That's what it is. They are becoming mad, absolutely mad people, recluses. There is one group of people who paid £3,000 for flying in the air, all right? £3,000 to fly in the air. I mean, yesterday I said that put your guru on the Leaning Tower of Pisa. It was built for that only. And throw him down and see if he can fly. If he can fly, then all right, you can pay £3,000 to him. And then ultimately they end up as recluses. So much so that if you show them a garlic, a little bud of the garlic, they are frightened. Can you imagine you get frightened of the vegetables? I mean, not even of animals, but of vegetables, and you think you are achieving a flying trick? Such stupidity exists that they go on falling into it and falling into it. And you are saints. You are chosen ones. You are great people. You have to achieve yourself. You don't understand, you have no self-esteem, that you give away to these horrible people who are nothing but devils. You can see it so clearly writ large on their faces. They are not going to talk against them. Many people tell me, Mother, why do you criticize them? I said, I will 100 times criticize them. Let them come and face me. None of them have put a filed a suit against me. I have talked about them with name. Nobody has filed a suit against me. They dare not, because I'll expose them very nicely. And these people have not only ruined your kundalini, all chances of your realization, but they have made you mad. So many people are epileptic. So many people are going to lunatic asylum. They are getting mad. And these people are supposed to be in charge of your spiritual evolution. One must understand that when you become something higher, you will have a higher awareness. You have to be master of yourself. Like if somebody starts jumping on the seat, that means he is not in his own control. I mean, somebody is making him jump. You should be able to guide the whole thing. Like, I would say, in a car, we have a brake and an accelerator, two powers. So this is the brake and this is the accelerator. You are trying to use it. You are balancing it. You are balancing it, you are trying to learn. Now you go to the left and right and you do all kinds of mistakes, all right. Then you learn it, you become a driver. Once you become the driver, the master who is sitting behind you gives you the seat of a master. You become the master. And that's what one should do, is to become the master. But supposing you are sitting in the car and your car takes you wherever it feels like, then are you the master of the car or the car is master of you? These people are so authoritarian. They put authority on you. They make you feel that you are nothing. Now, you ask them, what is your authority? But how can you ask? Because they have taken away your authority. In Sahaja Yoga, you become your authority. You become your absolute. You become your spirit. And then you judge others. And this is what it is, that you have to become masters yourself. I mean, these people are not equal to the dust of your feet. This is what it is. In the eyes of God. They take money from you and live on that. Parasites of the worst type are these lamas. They were parasites of these Tibetan people, poor people. They used to get money from them and live in Lhasa very nicely. Very great people, and having now in what Gobi desert, that Kambala or Shambhala and nonsense of that, let them all go to Gobi. Let them live there. That is the place meant for such people. They have taken money from the poor people, exploited them. And here, like parasites living on them, what work are they doing? They are doing no work. And they are the people who can show you how parasites are. Now, supposing if I tell you that you come and live with me, free of cost, will you accept any one of you? They take money from you. There's another fellow who has got 58 Rolls Royce, he wants to have 59th Rolls Royce. And you don't understand that you cannot give metal and get the spirit. You have to achieve your own spirit. It has to happen to you. You have to become the spirit. And the third force is your evolutionary force. It's the evolutionary force within us, which is the sustaining force by which we are sustained. Like carbon has four valences. Carbon is here. At this time, the carbon was created with four valences you see here. It's a tetravalent. But in the gross, it is carbon. But in the subtle, it is innocent. In the subtle, it is the innocent. Matter is innocent. If you hit it, it will hit you back. If you don't hit it, it will not hit you. So the innocence, the embodiment of innocence is here. And this chakra is the embodiment of innocence. And the deity of that is called as Sri Ganesh, who incarnated later on as the embodiment of innocence was Christ, our Lord, at that center where is the Ajna chakra. Now imagine the one who is the embodiment of innocence. These horrible nuns are trying to marry him. Will an innocent man marry? He doesn't know marriage. He doesn't know sex. He's beyond these things. He is not a human being. He is Omkara. He is Pranava. He is the divine power. How can he marry these women? These women with their baser things, they want to sublimate it and say that we want to marry this. If they want to marry, they should marry human beings. They cannot marry gods. And that is what he is, Christ. And the Christ advent is very important in the history of our evolution. If I talk about Christ to Indians, they say you are trying to make us Christians. If I talk to you about Sri Krishna, you will say I'm trying to make you Hindus. It's a very funny world, I must say. Christ has said, those who are not against me are with me. Who are those? You didn't allow him to speak. Hardly you allowed him to live for 3 years and you crucified him. He rode the donkeys, and I think all these donkeys have become now Christians. That was the symbol that they crucified him, and today again they are crucifying him by not accepting that they must have their spirit. They are to be born again. Now, they are to be born again means what? You certify I am born again? I mean, how can you certify yourself I am born again? It's artificial. Like this, we have made a mess of all of these great incarnations. Still, Christ has said everything can be forgiven. And it's true. Everything can be forgiven. All your sins can be forgiven. Everything can be forgiven. But become the spirit. If you don't become the spirit, then the dead will go to death. Spirit is the only living thing, and spirit is the only thing you should achieve, and that you should become. The rest of it is all mithya, is all falsehood, is all fake. Spirit emits the Brahma, the power, the cool breeze of the Holy Ghost, as they call it. That is the spirit within you that emits, and that's what you should achieve, which organizes, which thinks, which acts, which works out everything that has to be done, and also it loves. The whole thing put together is nothing but love. But love that only emits, which doesn't receive anything. It doesn't receive anything. I mean, if you want to hit me also, I will not receive it. I will not receive anything whatsoever you want to do to me. That's what it is, and that should happen to all of you, that you should not become any more recipient of all these nonsensical things, but just manifesting your love to others. That should happen to every seeker. And once that happens, you reach that state which I described yesterday as Nirvikalpa Samadhi. That Samadhi must come. That awareness, enlightened awareness you must have, you must achieve that. In Sahaja Yoga, one has to understand that it is your own progress which is important, and the progress of the whole that is important. It's not only your own progress, but the whole, the collectivity. Especially as he has said, that we should be chakra. Here is the point of our evolution, where we raised our head. Yesterday I told you that when we raised our head from animal kingdom, we took up the responsibility upon ourselves, and that chakra is nothing else but your great country, America. You have been talking big, no doubt. You think you are going to solve the problem of the whole world. Everywhere you go and meddle with, like Vietnam, here, there and that. And then you recede back thinking you have done a mistake. If you had achieved your spirit, then you don't have to go anywhere. Sitting here you can solve the problems. The all-pervading power with which you are connected will be amazed. Works out instantaneously. Sitting down here you can work it out. Only one thing it cannot do, where it is helpful. And that's the point. I come before you with a folded hand. That is, you have got your freedom to choose. If you are egoistical, if you are super ego means you are possessed, you will not choose. So with your own freedom, with your free will, you have to choose. And if you have chosen it with your free will, it can happen to you, otherwise it will not. Because your freedom has to be respected. You have to enter into the kingdom of God. You have to become absolutely free citizens of that great freedom. And if your freedom is not respected, you cannot enter. So first thing, your freedom has to be respected. If you don't want it, you cannot. I cannot force on you, nobody can force on you, nobody would like to. It is you have to ask for it. That's why he said, see. Christ has said, you have to see. If you see, if you ask for it, you have to knock. If you do not knock, the door won't open. Door should open for us. Everybody think, why sitting down here we should get it. No, you have to ask for it. Then only you can enter into the kingdom of God. Imagine a person who is a slave. Will you make him the king? We have to free from our ego and from our superego. That's why Christ is sitting down there at that point. Where you enter into the kingdom of God, which is the limbic area, on top there, when you awaken Christ, he sucks your ego and superego, all your karmas and your ego, all your conditionings and all your ambitions, everything sucked in. By sucking that, only you get this portion opened out, which is called as the fontanel bone area, and you get the cool breeze coming out. And many people have felt it yesterday. This is what it was said, that Christ should be awakened within us. He should be born within us, by which he sucks it. I wish Christians had carried this message properly to Indians. They did not. They gave such a funny idea about Christ that they put a loaf, imagine, loaf in the well and said, this is the meat of a cow. And they can't eat the cow's meat. So you all have become Christians. Like that, the villages after villages became Christians. Imagine what a message of Christ they gave to people. If they had told about this, then people would have known that the one who is promised as Mahavishnu, who is going to come on this earth to take away all our karmas and all that, people would have taken to another course. But it never came. So still they are poor things are plodding with their karmas. And here the gurus are coming and telling you that you have to get over your karmas. Imagine. Now what are these gurus paid for then? If you have to do anything happens, they say it is your karma. Then why are you paid for? You are taking all our money, everything from here and having big huge places for yourself, and where we are suffering here under pressures and all kinds of things, and you are telling us that this is because of your karma. If it is so, what is the need you to be there? So this is what one has to understand, the general history of these three things I told you. One is the power of desire, we call it as the Mahakali power, Mahakali power. This is the another power, is the power of action, which is Kriya Shakti. Actually this is called as Ichha Shakti and Kriya Shakti, but in our language, in Sahaja Yoga language it's called as Mahakali, this is called as Mahasaraswati, and this is as Mahalakshmi. Mahalakshmi is the power of evolution, and Christ Mother was the incarnation of Mahalakshmi power. And how and why, that I will tell you later on when I'll come to these, my chakras and chakras. I hope they have been able to follow my lecture and I have been able to explain. But if there is no explanation and if you want to know about something, you can ask. I know. Yes, this Freud, you see, your great Mr. Freud, must be another devil, I must say, to put these ideas. He didn't know anything, he had no business to talk about it. He was the most unauthorized person. What did he know? He didn't know anything. You read his book and find Jung, 1,000 times better. Jung, something new about it. You see, he got his realization also. This fellow Freud, he died of cancer. When you see he's dying of cancer, at least don't follow him. But you all have become Freudians. In London, there are only 12 Jungians, you see? And all of them are Jews, so they don't believe in Christ. So how can you talk to them? Jews don't believe in Christ. Why? And that's why they wanted to suffer. All right, so you had suffering. Had it. Now will you believe in Christ or not? They want to suffer, all right, have it. They asked for it. For 11 years, this thing was brewing up, this racialism in Germany. If you read the history of Germany, it's most surprising. And these Germans used to kill the Jews, do this, oh, we have to suffer, among themselves they used to say. If somebody is killed, they would never protest for 11 years. Then Hitler came into power, afterwards. And then he started doing all these things. For 11 years they were trying to suffer. Now they had a real royal suffering. That's what they had. Still, if you meet a Jew, he will still say, I don't believe in Christ. Who are you not to believe in him?
Many children suck their thumbs now.
That's this thumb they suck because you are catching on the left Swadhisthana. If you go to some horrible guru, they will start poor thing sucking this thumb, means left Swadhisthana. You are going to some unauthorized person, the child may be a realized soul and he is just sucking his thumb. We give so much trouble to our children, we have no idea. And now, so many realized souls are going to be born. There are so many. To our Sahaja Yogis now, Gavin has a daughter. Her name is Olympia, because I went to Olympics before that, you see. And so when I came back, I gave her the name Olympia. And if you see her, she's a tremendous child, tremendous child. If she was here, she would not allow me to speak. I have to take her in my lap and speak to you. Have you got her photograph? The green. Huh? All right. Oh! Must be my purse is not there. I don't know. So many children are born. There's another one. When I went to Greece, there was another child was born, Athena. And so many. There's another one who is called as Dattatreya. We have so many now in England, born realized. And they know. They get after people, you see, they work. We have lots of people about 10 or 12 children sitting down and lots of people, and they help me, they are around me and they tell me, here it is, they go on hitting and then they start improving the chakras and weaving bandhans and all that, and they work it out so well, they know so much. My own grandchildren, 4 of them, are first class realized, first class, absolutely top class. Some very great souls, and they are so simple and they understand things so well. Like the younger one, she's the youngest, was about 3 years of age, and she was going to some nursery school and she brought a paper. Imagine, in a little children's school, they sent a paper saying that there's a course on for youth, for your transformation. So she bought the thing and she said, what is written in this thing? I said, you can change if you join this course for 100 rupees, you have to go to a hotel. So this little one says, how can that be possible? By paying 100 rupees, you cannot just do it. The Kundalini must be awakened, otherwise how can you? And Kundalini doesn't understand money. The little one says, 3-year-old. The elder one says, but by doing course, if you can do it, my father has done 14 courses, his Kundalini is not awakened. You see, how simple it is for them to see, but you cannot see. It's your ego. You have overdeveloped ego. You think you can study. You mean to say people who are not educated are not going to get realization? It's a living thing. Do we study for our breathing? Imagine we have to go to library to understand how to breathe. What will happen to all of us? We'll never reach the library. Yes.
Mother, I did feel yesterday that something very, I can understand, but was very nice, very good happened. But I'm not sure what to do. I didn't go today to the workshop, and can I find out?
I mean, if you don't come to the workshop, what should I do?
Can I get what?
No, I would.
I'm coming here.
Put your willpower. What I'm saying, put your willpower. I'm here only for 5 days, not more than that. Now only 4 days. Now make best use of me. What else can I say? All right? I am staying in that hotel because of you. All right? That you could come and see me in the morning time. Those who came, ask Kamal. How much he was helped? How much he learned? How will you learn unless and until you come to me? All right? You must come. Put little willpower. You see, supposing I had taken $100 from you, you would have come. Definitely, I know American temperament. You see, I asked them why they do it. You see, they said it's like this. You buy a ticket for a picture or a, say, for a play, all right? And the play is horrible, but you say we paid, so let us sit down. We paid for it. You see, everything is paid for. It's paid for. That's why. But you cannot pay me and you cannot buy me. But you must tell yourself that if I am a realized soul, I should know all about it. All right? Put in your willpower. Put in your willpower. Because I cannot mesmerize you and I cannot force you. See, all those who came to me this morning were very much helped and are much better now. Ask any one of them how much happier they are. Some people who had a very bad bow or back and all that, I cured them, and somebody had a pain here, I cured him. Everybody was helped, no doubt. Everybody was helped very much. Those who didn't come would be lagging in their progress, definitely, no doubt.
Where are you located?
Yes, we'll make an announcement at the end of the program, precisely where you should come.
Yes, of course. I'm sticking on to that place. I'm not getting out at all. Actually, they lock me in. And they keep somebody to watch me. I may disappear, you see, in the thin air. So I'm just there for you, waiting for you. I've come all the way for you only, isn't it? What have I got to do in this New York, the great? Yes?
Speaker mentioned he had trouble with his chakras. Other people have trouble. So can you help those people too?
Of course. He's saying that I said I had problems with my chakras, other people have trouble with, can you help them?
Of course, you can also help yourself and I can help you also and you will know everything about it. Everything you will know. You see, if I know what's there, if I have all the powers, what's there? Why should you believe in me? You should have your own power. This is simple. All right? Any other question? They are very positive people.
What about the people who did pranayama, the rays from the moon?
You cannot do it by effort. It's not correct. On the contrary, pranayama gives you sinus problem and so many other problems. And this Hamsa chakra gets caught with the pranayama. This is a very bad chakra in which once caught, it's very difficult to correct. You cannot do meditation. You have to be in meditation. Once it happens, you are there. You are in thoughtless awareness. You are watching everything like a witness. The whole thing looks like a drama.
It seems to come and go. Sometimes meditation comes and then it's not there and then it's there again.
No, it cannot be. If you know everything about Kundalini and if your Kundalini is really done, then it doesn't work out. In the beginning, you have to be careful for a month only. For a month, you have to give little intensive care and then it's all right. It's like a patient coming out of intensive care. But you have to treat yourself, first of all, like a patient. Look after yourself, put full effort to understand everything, cure yourself, and you are all right. But put some willpower, you see. You should have come. I asked them, well, what about the boy who wanted to get married? I could have got you a bride today. All right, but now you might miss the point. Yes, my child.
Something very strange just happened. I got very angry when you talked about
the
Jews.
About
who? About the Jews. Because my ancestors were poor.
You should not be angry with me.
No, but I want to tell you what happened. I'm not angry.
All right.
I got very angry when you said that. My ancestors were poor, ignorant peasants in Russia. And they were not Germans. And they did not have any money. And they did not know what was going on. Anyway, and I believe in the Christ spirit, but I don't believe in Jesus Christ.
How can you say that? All right, we'll see.
Okay.
All right, we'll
so anyway,
see.
I have something wrong with the base of my spine. And it was hurting me terribly before I got angry, and all of a sudden it stopped hurting.
What
is that happening? I'm not angry at you. I was angry at that idea.
No, not. It's not. It's true. I was also a Jew once upon a time, for your information.
What?
I was also a Jew in one of my lives, all right? And I have all sympathies with them. But they are foolish. To say that they should suffer, why should they suffer?
Well, suffering is ridiculous.
All right. All right. Then they say that we don't believe in Christ. What right have they got to say so? They have to believe, because Christ was a Jew himself. You know, I was born in an Indian Christian family in India. No Indian Christian believes in me. You'll be surprised, not a single Indian Christian. All are Muslims, Hindus, Jains, Parsis. Everybody, you will believe you are Americans, but Indian Christians don't believe me. That's what.
Indian Christians don't believe me.
That is setting it up.
And you believe it. They are the only people who don't believe it.
Too close.
The jealousy, I think. I don't know what it is. It's funny. But if I was, say, if I was the president of India, they would have been all very close to me. My nearest relations would have been there. See, because then they think materially they can have advantage. But believing in me, for them, is very difficult. Except for my own brothers and sisters, because they know me from my childhood, and my father himself, and my mother. I don't think any Indian Christian really believes in me. There are people who have cast my horoscope and he said, you are tremendous. I mean, just can't believe that this is your horoscope and all that. But he cannot believe in me. See, there's still a barrier because he's an Indian Christian. So perhaps they think to be Indian Christian is very low, and how can I be something so great? Maybe that. Or they don't believe in themselves. I don't know what it is. It's a fact. And that's why Jews did not believe in Christ. And even today they are trying. Very funny things, like there was a questionnaire, I will tell you, in London. The Jews are trying, you see, they have money. So they told the Times people to put some sort of an article against Christ. And what they said was, that in the Bible it was said that a girl is going to give birth to Christ according to the Hebrew language, but not a virgin. Now in those days, girl meant a virgin. Even today in India, Kanya means a virgin and also means a girl. I mean, they didn't have 80-year-old girls as we have in America in those days, you see. And it means that. And now another logical thing one can see, that if the girl was not going to give birth, then is the man going to give birth? Why did they say girl? If it was just a woman, why did they say particularly girl? Such absurd things about this shroud of Christ also. They created another controversy for nothing at all. That the shroud of Christ, and it is his shroud, no doubt. But when he died, he was tied. See, from both the sides was pulled out. So very longish face and all that. He was not that longish type of a person. And because, you see, after all, the color is wearing is part of the body. It cannot be three-dimensional. So it looks very thin and sickly and pulled out stuff. It is his shroud, no doubt. But this was the shroud that covered him when he was just taken out and was covered and put in the grave. Now they are saying this was the shroud they used is a proof that he was taken and smuggled into another country and he never resurrected. This is the speciality of these Jews that establishing now. I said now anybody who has common sense, if they have to smuggle a body from one country to another, will they cover it with a shroud which has got all the blood stains on it? Think of these people, how they are after Christ. They talk of Jehovah, who is an abstract God, and they are the grossest people, I can tell you. They think of money, 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 fighters. They talk of the abstract. Now we have many, many Sahajyogis who are Jews. Sahajyogis who are Jews. And they feel it. And they feel so worried. So worried. Two of them had come here, now they have gone away. About their parents and about other people. What's going to happen? They see it because Christ exists. I can prove it to you on Kundalini. I'll prove it to on Kundalini. Kundalini won't rise unless and until you accept Jesus Christ himself. Nobody else. But Jesus Christ. I'll prove it to you.
No,
this you are accepting at this level. It's not the point. At that level you'll accept. At that level when you'll become the spirit. At this level whatever you're accepting is your own concept because you're born as a Jew. If you're born as a Christian, you would have been, I'm Jesus Christ. There are many like that who are saying like that. There's one gentleman who's saying, I'm Jesus Christ now. I said, put him on the water. Can he walk? Just let him walk. One foot up and one foot down. It's very simple, you know, to believe into anything. Khomeini believes he's God himself. I mean, how can you say that? There is nothing absolute about it. You have to find absolute. All right? When you find your absolute, then you should say this is the truth, not believe. All right? Many Jews now have become Sahajyogis, they have become the spirit. No, I'm just telling you that many Jews have become and they are following it up and understanding. You are nothing, you are the spirit. I know that. I see you are the spirit, but you have to become. Spirit has to come in your awareness. It has to come in your central nervous system. It exists. I see that. Clear.
Child
what?
Of child abuse, particularly in this country, and where children are very badly treated by their parents. And some other person who was not you said, well, these people have karma that they haven't, they have answered this and they have children and so forth. But some of these, if some of these children are realized beings, why do they have to have, why have child with an extremely abused parent who almost killed them?
Talking.
And I'd like you to make some comment about that.
She's asking for you to comment on child abuse and all the dreadful things that happen, and she's wondering why, if there are so many of these young children who are realized souls, why they have to suffer so much.
You see, in these countries, only the extremely highly developed people will be born, or the absolutely the most negative, the Antichrist will be born. The mediocres are not going to take birth in this country, where the children are treated like this. They'll be born in India. That's why we are having population problems.
Well, I'll tell you, my mother tried to kill me when I was 10 years old, pulled a knife on me.
That's why you see why we have a population problem in India, because you ill-treat your children. And the children don't want to be born here. In England, a radio fellow came and asked me, as usual, sinister as usual, he asked me, that what about your population problem? I said, you are responsible, I'm sorry. He said, how are we responsible? I said, in England, two children are killed every week, statistically. Which sane child would be born in that horrible country, except for somebody who is of a very terrific temperament, a dynamic, who will come and kill them. And these children are born to take over. Let them grow. We'll teach all of them a lesson. Don't you worry. We'll pass through all that. You'll overcome that.
My mother told me, she said, you were different from us and we don't want
you. I know they're satanic. I know they're satanic. They are satanic people. But they'll be put right. Don't you worry. These children will surpass them. They are great. They are dynamic. They are special people. Don't you worry about them. They'll be all looked after. They'll get over it.
Any other questions, or shall we have it now? The thing is to get it, and then the questions get answered.
Now, what about your Bhagavan? Better take out from your place. Better take it out.
Take it off.
It's
going to absorb vibrations and stop your kundalini from rising.
Oh. Absolutely, you'll feel so hot in the beginning only. You feel terribly hot.
Is Sushya Guru?
Yeah, well, Bhagwan was my guru, but then I left.
But you better leave him.
Where beads.
Why? No. Beads also. No good. Nothing, anything that reminds you of him, throw him out in the street. Horrible fellow, he's already finished.
Yes? Yeah, tell me something about Bhagwan. Who is he?
Tomorrow. I'll tell him who he is.
The problem is this guy in America, a 64,000 acre
land. Yeah.
You Americans are very, very liberal people. You have asked all the Antichrist to come and settle down here. And their vibrations are going to explode, and all earthquakes are going to come in this country if you don't throw them away. Your media is not going to listen to me, they don't want to come to me and listen to this. This country will be destroyed. You take it from me. You give them ranches and all that.
He bought it.
Nothing, you give up this dirty cloth. Horrible, everything is horrible, very bad vibration. I'll tell you tomorrow who he is. All right? All of them were devils, very well known to me long time back. About 14,000 years back I knew them, one better than the other. He's the devil. Can't you see? What is holiness in him? His whole ashram is gutted and all that finished. Indians never liked him. You can see the pulsation of the kundalini. You can see the rising of the kundalini. You can feel the pulsation on the pontineal bone here. Then when the pulsation stops, then you see the cool breeze coming out. You can feel it. You see, you should feel.
Can you feel the devil in another person or the spirit in another person? That's what I
want to know. Yes. You can also feel it. Everyone will feel. There's no devil in you. None of you. You are all saints. But the trouble is, these devils have put some spirits in you. You are possessed, which you have to take. That you will yourself feel.
On my way walking here, I felt very hot. My whole body was very hot.
I know.
And it was cool out, I could understand.
That's it. Coming to me. You will feel hot even. I told you that you better change this dress of yours next
the
time.
Color is not
good? Horrible color. This one is why to announce it.
What?
Why to announce that you are a sannyasi? If you are, you are. You don't announce it, do you?
He doesn't need to wear this color. But he should not wear this color.
Throw it away. Throw away all his books, throw away his photographs, throw away everything.
But the color is not Bhagwan. The color is God, isn't it?
No. This color
white
is symbolizing something. Yeah, it symbolizes someone. It's a symbol. And that gives you bad vibrations. It does. Moreover, I'm deadly against this color from the very beginning, which I'll tell you tomorrow. Red is first class.
Red, not orange. Not orange.
Red one, not orange.
I see.
All right?
You're known as the orange people all over the world by that red.
You don't know. The other day somebody came to me and said, he said, Mother, I have to make one prayer to us. What? He said, please save all the orange people. I said, which are these orange ones? Then he said, these Bhagwans. Bhagwan. Bhagwan can't even smell a flower.
Sniffs everybody to check that they don't have some beautiful...
Imagine the Bhagwan. In the books of the Vishnu is written, he is the one who is fond of flowers. The goddess is the fond of flowers. She is the one who is fond of lotus. She sits in the lotus. She can't live without the flowers. I can't exist without flowers. And this fellow is... Have you ever heard any saintly person to take flowers for that person? Can't you see that? What he wants is gutters. He can't bear the perfumes. He must have gutters. Dirty fellow he is. Send him to some bathroom and dump him down there. He's already gone to his room. Don't you worry. Horrible. Dirty, filthy man. Useless. You must show them this film. Have you got it?
The film was called The God Has Fled.
Uh-huh. The God Who Has Fled.
He'd run away from India and now he's hiding somewhere here and there.
I mean, your media has not even time to come and see that. You see, what to do with them horrible medias that you have here? But the best part of it, they published an advertisement, somebody told me, in the Time magazine of London. And do you know, Time magazine is closed permanently. It's closed. They are inauspicious, see. These clothes are inauspicious. I hope I'll be able to give realization, but with these clothes, I don't know. I don't know.
What about praying for somebody who is going to a false guru? What about praying for somebody who is false?
You see, when you are praying, to whom are you praying? To God, all right? You should be first connected or not? We are praying without our connection, like we are telephoning without the connection established. We spoil the telephone or better. But first, when you are connected, then even if you say it once, it works out. But you should be connected. You must enter into the kingdom of God. For example, I am not an American citizen. I have no right as an American citizen, isn't it? You have to become the citizen of God. Kingdom, then you have every right to ask for anything, otherwise you have no right. Unless and until you become a spirit, you don't have any right, whatever you may say. And if you say, I am that, people will put you in the jail. That's what it is. You have to become. Then the prayers has meaning. Krishna has said clearly, there should be ananya bhakti. Ananya means when there is not the other, when you are connected, that should be the time when you can worship. But ask these Hare Rama people, till they get their throat cancer, they are busy with that. What am I to do? They are not called orange, they are called what? Skinhead. And they are selling in the market that stuff, you know, which they wear here, and they put that down. Like a little hair coming up, you see. Wig is a special wig, Hare Rama wig. And they dance in that Oxford surfaces. Shameful to see that. They wear those saris and dhotis and everything falls down and they're dancing like mad. We are mad in the love of Sri Krishna. Imagine. What a caricature. And their guru is to look like one of our jockey called Leslie Piggott. Have you seen his face? Imagine worshipping Sri Krishna looking like that. Actually, Vishuddhi gives you a face, a special face. Vishuddhi should. But the face he had was all kinds of wrinkles all over the places, just like Leslie Piggott. He could be a good jockey, but he died now. He's the person calling himself as God's devotee. Imagine shame for God also to have such devotees who are TB patients.
All the gurus today negative, I mean people like Sai Baba.
Which one? This with the hair?
Baba, yes.
He's horrible. He's a big devil.
Have a man in poverty.
Ah, horrible. There are real Hindus also. I wouldn't say that they're all horrible.
There are real.
They're in the market. Real ones are there, many are there, but they're not in the market. One of them I asked him to come here. He stayed in New York only for 2 days and ran away. He wouldn't stay here. But they are very hard taskmasters. They are all. And you will become. Why are you worried about anybody else? You are going to become even better gurus than they are.
All right.
Did you make some
comment about Ramana Maharshi?
About what?
About Ramana Maharshi.
He was a realist.
No
doubt.
Because most people do recognize him as somebody who really was.
That's true, but not his disciples are horrid.
Well, I don't know anything about them.
No, he was a realized. So like Christ himself was an incarnation himself, but his disciples, the Christians, God save us from them.
What about Ramakrishna?
Not at all. He was not a realized. He was a seeker like you, but he outdid everything. It was too much. I mean, what was the need to cry like this all the time, like a madman? He was dancing and all that. There was no need to do all this drama. I think it was a very dramatic.
Devotional.
Huh?
It was more like a devotional sign. Too much left.
Too much left. Nonsense. You know, God must be fed up with such people. Like my granddaughter. We had in the neighborhood, there was a temple. And they were dancing and singing like that. So she told me, Grandma, you see, God must have already run away from that temple, no doubt. Now I'm going to run away. I'm fed up of these people. You know, you should not pester God also like this. This is too much. And what right have you got? One thing is that supposing if I want to meet your president, supposing I even want to meet your president, I must have a proper protocol. I just cannot go and start shouting, oh, president, as if he's in my pocket. In the same way, this is nonsense, absolute nonsense. You can see yourself. Ramakrishna ashram people mostly dying of cancer, I must say. Cancer has taken over, I must say. I'm sorry. But at least, I must have seen at least 100 cases from that who are coming with cancer. I mean, he's left-sided. And this Satya Sai Baba, this devil, the real one was there. Shirdi Sai Nath was real. But the second one, the one who is, he gives you heart attacks.
Could I ask you about Sri Aurobindo?
Aurobindo.
What do you think?
Well, I went, just as a visitor, when I was in India in 73, I went to the ashram and monastery, just on a visit, and I got some very bad vibrations there.
That's your answer.
But I did not consider
that French woman of his was a drunkard. The French woman he had was a drunkard. And she used to collect nothing but diamonds. And she had such big, huge diamonds. And she was going to become young after some time. God knows what happened to her. Now she's finished. And they used to say, if you have to come to their ashram, then you must give all your assets to these jhanis, Aurobindo and his mother, or whatever relationship they had, or nonsense.
Well, I had a terrible spiritual,
spiritually
I felt lost,
so it was
terrible.
That's what it is.
That's because you're a seeker and you're becoming aware of negativity. You're starting to perceive it.
Well, I wasn't seeking for anything there. I just went on a deliberate
story. Horrible there. Absolutely horrible people. They make you mad.
But one almost drove me crazy.
I said,
my whole part of my body became inflamed, and I almost died. In 2 years, I was in pain.
I mean, this is nothing. He has given blisters to people all over. I've cured people. I mean, all of you should really write to your newspapers and things and ask them, what are you doing about this man? How can he buy anything? You should prohibit. In India, doesn't he buy anything? He can. He can't. The government has put down that.
Yes.
the more realized that you become, and you become more healthy?
Of course. Of course. The doctors have no place there. You save all your money from the doctors and all that. You become the doctor. You should become more healthy. You should become more wise. You should become more alert. You should become more dynamic. You should become controlled over everyone. See? No more you are greedy. I mean, it's a different thing. Your priorities change completely. That's what you deserve. That's what you are. And that's what you should have. You have earned it. This is your bank balance I'm telling you about. I'm here just to sign your check. If you have the bank balance. That's what you are.
What is your role in helping one realize itself?
What is mine?
What is your role in all this, in helping one realize oneself?
If I could do it myself, what is your role?
I don't know what is my role is. I don't know.
What do you do to make it right?
Well, I don't do anything either.
Right.
You find out for yourself after.
No, no, no. I'll tell you what. It's simple. Now, will you ask the sun what is your role? It is the sun. It has to do it. Just do it. You better do it. What will you do? It's your nature. It's my nature. No, but there's no role as such. It's nature. What can I do? It just happens. I enjoy. I want to share my enjoyment. You are my children. I have to give you. It's my love. I enjoy my love. That's all. It's rather difficult to understand a person like that, isn't it? But there is one. Can be one like that. In all this mess, there can be one like that. Who just does it out of love. That's it's just love and compassion. It's ocean of compassion. I can't get over it, I'm sorry. I have a very good husband, a very good family. I'm a very happily married woman. Everything is there. But without you, I cannot enjoy life. Cannot. You all have to get it. It's my job. It's my mission. That's how I'm here. That's how I'm created. I'm just made for this. I'm fixed for it in American language. Or we can say all set for it. All right? There's no role, nothing. It's just I'm set. I have to do it.
So what I mean is that there is a method, right?
No method, no thing. As far as, there's a divine method, you see, which cannot be explained in ordinary words. Like you cannot explain how a flower becomes a fruit. All right? But I raise your kundalini by my own raising. By raising my own kundalini. I put your kundalini on top of my kundalini. This is an immaculate, you can say, immaculate rebirth. I put you in my heart and give you realization from my soul. Alright? But how I do it, that I can't tell. But you will also do it. Once you get it, your vibrations will do it automatically.
How long does it take to get the beginning of it?
How?
How long does it take?
Oh, split of a second. Just split of a second. But if you are all right, otherwise I have to cleanse you a little bit. I have to cleanse you a little bit. All right?
I felt very hot when I asked you that silly question, because of course it was not, it was me and I'm willing, of course. I felt. So, I'm willing. We will be shown more how to, I don't know what to do to. We'll find out.
That's it.
Here in America, she's going to establish a group, all of you together.
No, Harman has offered his place for this thing, very sweet of him to have offered. No, Harman has offered his place and I'm going to sanctify it, I'm going to see the place and all that, and we'll start our center there. Christine is here. She's a very old Sahajogini in the sense that she came to be one of the first seven I had for 4 years. She's one of them and she knows a lot about Sahajog. Then in Boston we've got Steve, and you all are going to grow very fast, and we've got here another one, Christine, who is in Boston. Then I don't know about Tracy, she's going to come down and settle down here. And also, who else? Is Marsha. But Marsha has now gone to Philadelphia and she's going back to England, and she's going to come back with her husband and settle down in Philadelphia. So you are going to have these people here to help you and if whatever guidance you need. And you yourself will start understanding it very well, very soon. 4 or 5 days are sufficient to suit you. So the reaction comes to you as heat, so if you try to be... All right. I didn't do anything, I'm just sitting here, I'm not doing anything. All right. Now let's have it.
Anybody who has their shoes on, just rip them off.
Yes, please. That much is the simplest thing to understand. Now, can I remove this part of the thing that is hanging onto my neck? What has it has improved anything? I don't know. Did it?
It's for the television. For the. It's for this.
Ah, that's the one. I don't understand. Whatever you say, only thing be satisfied, right? Good. There, still is there, not lost.
But I seem to have a lot of the time at home now. I seem to have it at home, you know, when I'm just at home, it seems to be always there.
She seems most to have it time, all the time.
Most of the time it's there.
Good. Keep it up. And then I'll tell you everything about your theology later on, right?
Yeah, well, I'm sorry that I didn't come to you. I said I was going to come when I did it, but I'm going to come tomorrow.
All right. And I'll tell you all about it. All about it. Slowly you will know everything. You see, there are many things which are true and many things which are false. And with vibrations you can verify.
But you know, Mataji, what is very sad is that things that aren't true are being distorted. And that is almost worse. When there is an element of truth and then people see that and then it's twisted. I mean, it is almost more harmful than having a false guru exposed because that is too obvious.
No person could be more aware of it than me.
And some terrible things are going on in Christianity. They're destroying people.
You don't know how much concern I have. No, right.
It is worse. What is happening in Christianity is worse than what is happening with false gurus, and I know this.
I mean, you can't say that in both ways. It's everywhere just the same. I'm very aware. You use Christ's name in that fashion. Really bring such discredit.
They're using Christian theology to torture people.
I'm very much concerned. On my own level, I'm working it out in my own way.
And I was a nun for 10 years. I mean, I have seen horrible things.
She was a nun. 10 years, contemplative nun.
And I've gotten into such spiritual pain that I almost went out on my own. I mean, I suffered. And there was some reason why I had to have that suffering. But I saw, and I mean, it is awful. It's terrible.
I know.
I mean, they're actually preventing...
You know, this Pope of yours, I went to Krakow. I went with my husband to Krakow.
Oh, just about my shrine?
Just before he became the Pope. And you see, he's a big man, so they took me... they said, what are you interested in? I said, I'm interested in churches. So they took me to Krakow. And they had a mass. You see, this fellow came and shook my hands. And I raised his kundalini, all right. And it pierced through also. But it again went back because he's a Christian like that. And I work on him quite a lot. But do you know what happened? Recently there was a photograph of Pope.
and his hand came out like this, and the hand is missing. His hand is missing.
I know what you were saying. I know about this.
And that photograph was published. They don't know how it was published. Let them see these points. And Rome, in Rome, people are very much against. Very much against the whole institutions. None
That's horrible.
We have somebody here whom you should talk to, and then they'll tell you about it. And the one who has written this book that went, he was also wanting to become a priest and all that. He was very much against it. Actually, against Catholicism, I spoke about 2 years back in your wedding.
Oh, I'd just like to ask you if your own Christian background is Catholic or Protestant. I mean, just from what, when you were born. You said you were born into a Christian family. Did you have a Protestant background or a Catholic one as a child?
Lutheran.
Pardon?
Lutheran.
Lutheran.
I was baptized by Lutherans. And then my father was the member of the Church of Scotland, Presbyterian. I have no background. Neither my father had. My father was a very learned man and a very important soul. He knew 14 languages and he had mastered Sanskrit language and all that.
I was wondering, because I know that from the thing on your book, I know that you came from Madhya Pradesh. And so I figured that you, I was thinking, well, maybe she's a South Indian Catholic, but I thought she's from Madhya Pradesh, so she probably isn't.
She thinks you're from Madhya Pradesh, you're not from Madhya Pradesh.
No, actually that time, that Madhya Pradesh was in Maharashtra. Now it's called that. You see, that part is Maharashtra.
Yeah, but I was thinking at first that you were a South Indian Catholic, and then when I saw where you were born, I knew you weren't. So I was trying to figure out what your, because it was important to me knowing whether you had a
That is the center of India. That station is the center of India. That's where I was born.
Yeah, was
in the Tropic of Cancer.
Yeah, well, I know India very well, and that particular place is about 50 miles north of Nagpur. Yeah.
That's the place is placed on Tropic of Cancer. Mecca is also Tropic of Cancer.